You have chosen a couple passages that I want to read that drive us very well. And in Philippians chapter 2, it says this, "Don't be selfish. Don't try to impress others. Be humble, thinking of others much better than yourselves. And don't look out for your own interests, but look out for the interest of others too. You must have the same attitude that Christ had." Then Psalm 54:4 says this, "But God is my keeper, and it is the Lord who keeps me alive." So in this passage it says, take on the same attitude that Christ had, which is to sacrifice your life for others. And then God is going to be your helper. The Lord is the one who keeps you alive. If you're committed to living a Christ-centered life, then I'm asking you to join your hands together. Bruce, you take Amber to be your wedded wife, to live together following God's design for your relationship, and do you promise to love, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others? Do you promise to keep yourself only under her so long as you both shall live, do you? Amber, you take Bruce to be your wedded husband, to live together following God's design for your relationship, and do you promise to love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others? Do you promise to keep yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live, do you? Amber, I asked, as you know, I asked Bruce to write some things about why you and all of the opportunities he has. Why has he chosen you and decided that he wants to grow old with you and be best friends even when you're old? What is it about you? And here's what he said. "My relationship with you, Amber, is the first time I've felt an undeniable trust. I trust you implicitly. You've seen all sides of me, and yet you continue to press forward with love and devotion toward me. You trust God's plan for me. Although people know I'm a good guy, you see and feel it. You feel it deeply. You know and understand the person I am. You know my heart almost to the deepest that there is. And our bond is based on God above anything else. You have the deepest prayer and attention towards God of anybody I know. You have the ability to be single-focused on God, even with life going on around you. You desire to please me more than anyone. You influence me. You hold me accountable in my relationship with Christ. You bring out the best of me, and that is what I've been longing for." So Bruce, I'll ask you to repeat after me. I, Bruce, take you, Amber, as my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy word." Bruce, Amber had a few things to say about you. Here's what she said. "You want God to be our number one priority. You make me feel so special and cherished by the attention you give me in words and action. You make me feel safe. You make me feel protected. I feel so safe in your arms. You're so good with the children around you. I love your laugh, your outstanding social skills, and you're so darn cute and handsome. I know how you put others before yourself, and you let me vent and vent, and vent, and vent. I love how you make things seem so easy when they're complicated. In a nutshell, you're masculine, you're smart, you're thoughtful, you're caring, and you're sensitive." Amber, if you'll repeat after me. I, Amber, take you, Bruce, as my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's will. Father, I pray that you will be honored in the commitments that have been made. I pray that you would give them strength to put their hope in you, that they would seek you first in everything they do. I pray that you would give them strength to serve when serving is not easy. And Father, I pray that you will honor them as they seek to honor you. I pray this in Jesus' name. Bruce, what token do you give as a symbol of your love for Amber? And Amber, will you wear it proudly showing your love for him? Repeat after me. I give this ring to you as a symbol of my never-ending love and devotion. Everything I have belongs to you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Remember, what token do you give the symbol of your love for Bruce? Bruce, will you wear it proudly showing your love for her? I give this ring to you as a symbol of my never-ending love and devotion. Everything I have belongs to you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for the commitments that they have made. Thank you that every time they see these rings, they'll be reminded of your never-ending love and devotion to each of them and the commitments that they've made to pursue one another at all times. Father, give them strength. Father, I pray that they would have amazing, great days together. And I pray that in the hard days that they can still find peace and contentment because you are their source and you are their strength. And we pray that you will honor these commitments. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. So one of the things that we've talked about is the centrality of Christ. That your desire is to build a family that's based on Christ. And the beauty of what I know about you is that you want people to see Jesus in you. And so your goal as a couple is not just to be married and to be happy. I hope that all that happens. But more, that as people see you interact, they see Christ in you. And that there would be hundreds, if not more, of people who would come to Christ because they just see the way you operate and live your life. And it's going to be the presence of Christ in you who does it. It's not you trying harder because we're all messy people. It's Christ in you. And so as you see these colors, the red representing you, Amber, the black representing you, Bruce, and then the white represents the presence of Christ. And there's a passage that speaks directly to that, but it talks about you're just better together than you are separate. And with the presence of Christ, then so much more can happen because you have the creator of the universe living in you and operating through you. Here's what Ecclesiastes 4 says. Two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone, they're in real trouble. Likewise, two people lying close, they can certainly keep each other warm, but how can one be warm alone? A person standing alone can be attacked and defeated, but two stand back to back and conquer. Three are even better, for a triple braided cord is not easily broken. Thank you. Ephesians 3:20 says, "Now all glory to God who is able, through his mighty power at work within us, to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think. Glory to him in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations forever and ever. Amen." It's God who is able, who's at work within you to do far greater than what you could ever do on your own. That's why it's so important for you to pursue him. Psalm 46:10 says, "Be still and know that I'm God. I will be honored by every nation. I'll be honored throughout the world." Let's pray together. Father, thank you for the commitments that Amber and Bruce have made to each other. Thank you that they desire to put their hope not in each other, but to put their hope and trust in you. Father, I pray that you will honor their commitments. I pray you give them strength. I pray that people would see Christ in them. And I pray that you would be honored in the way they work through hard times and good times, how they pursue friendships, how they work. God, I pray that people would see Christ in them and that you would be honored. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. By the power vested in me, it is my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, may no one ever attempt to separate. Bruce, you may kiss your bride. Yeah. It is my privilege to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Bruce Benda.